What you are observing is 462 metric tons of rock every second being ejected in Hawaii out of the Kilauea Volcano's two summit vents. This occurred at speeds exceeding not only the fastest baseball pitch ever thrown, but also the fastest tennis serve ever made. This molten rock was specifically ejected upwards at an initial velocity of 181.5 miles per hour or 292.1 kilometers per hour. From the moment these hundreds of tons of 1200 degrees Celsius basaltic lava were ejected upwards, it would take a full 16.54 seconds to reach the ground, and this assertion ignores air resistance, so the true length of time it took was even longer. This occurred as part of Kilauea's 27th spectacular episode of multi-hour-long lava fountaining, which on June 29th reached a maximum height of 1,100 feet or 335 meters. That process clearly involved an impressive amount of energy, and what allowed this to occur was gas and the rising magma coming out of solution to form bubbles, and these bubbles rapidly expanded as overlying pressure decreased, with this process propelling the magma upwards. Across the time span of a little under 11 hours, 6.2 million cubic meters of lava was in place, temporarily adding another 7 meters or 23 feet to the caldera floor. Volumes of ash were also emitted, forming this plume scene all the way from the summit of Mauna Kea 31 miles to the northwest. Thankfully, the vast majority of ash harmlessly fell to the west of Kilauea's summit caldera where no one lives, adding further to the up to 50 feet thick of tephra in place since the cyclical eruptive activity began on December 23rd of last year. Since then, 125.4 million cubic meters of fresh molten rock has been in place, meaning if this rate holds throughout the remainder of the year, that Kilauea will erupt in 2025 more than it did between 2019 and 2024. I am only saying this to once again reiterate how special of a time it is at Kilauea, both as a volcanologist and as a tourist. Just look at all of these people, they are clearly having a great time and of course are safe. There are no signs yet that this episodic activity will stop anytime soon, with the 28th episode of lava fountaining and the opinion of Geology Hub also likely to reach above 1,000 feet in height and begin before the end of July 10th. However, if you have lived on the Big Island of Hawaii or visited this popular volcano in the past, specifically decades ago, you might know that the ongoing activity is not the first recent instance of episodic lava fountaining. In fact, three other such instances occurred since 1900, specifically in 1959, 1969 to 1974, and 1983 to 1986. For some additional context, here are where those eruptions occurred. The 1959 eruption greatly filled the Kilauea Iki pit crater just to the eastern edge of Kilauea's modern caldera, produced 17 episodes of lava fountaining, and lasted for 35 days. The 1969 to 1974 eruption produced 12 episodes of lava fountaining at the eastern rift zone vent known as Mauna Ulu, 6 miles to the southeast. The 1983 to 1986 Pu'u'o'u eruption was quite similar, also occurring in the East Rift Zone, eventually resulting in 44 episodes of lava fountaining. With that figure in mind, there's a chance that the current activity might eventually surpass the highest number of lava fountaining episodes a Kilauea eruption has had later in the year. Also, here is a quick reference to the highest sustained lava fountains each of those four distinct eruptions produced. So yes, the current eruption hasn't yet surpassed the maximum lava fountain heights attained at those other three eruptions, which reach as much as 52% higher. Regardless, this is still Kilauea's first series of summit or near-summit lava fountaining episodes since 1959. If you are wondering what the flames are in this video clip, they actually are the result of rising hydrogen gas igniting from underlying magma. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.